Welcome to the Sun Bowl game presented by Hyundai here on CBS. It's NCAA college football as part of the Bowl Championship Series on CBS. And are you guys excited for this? Every game so far in the second round of the BCS playoffs has been decided by one play, one final play. And guys, get ready because we're about to see an offensive showdown between the Baylor Bears and the Oregon Ducks. Two teams that are ranked up in the top five in total offense. This is Darren Thomas versus Robert Griffin III. The Oregon Ducks wearing their yellow here for the Sun Bowl. What better colors to pick than yellow for the Sun Bowl? Of course, like every bowl game, here's the flyover. The Ducks in the famous Idaho Potato Bowl made quick work of the BYU Cougars, and for the Baylor Bears, they made short work of the Conference USA champions, the Southern Miss Golden Eagles there in the Insight Bowl. And there you're taking a look at Darren Thomas. And we found out a little while ago that for the Ducks, they're getting ready to lose one of their big stars to the NFL draft. That was, reported a couple of days ago, but more so reported here is Michael James, the running back, who has decided that he's going to forego his senior year and enter into the NFL draft. So Oregon losing a monster star, but to make this decision in the middle of this playoff run, maybe a little added motivation to his team that, hey, this is my last time here. And if I'm going to go out, I want to go out with a bang with you guys. Not like last season where we were eliminated in the second round. This is as far as Oregon got last year for the second round before they were eliminated by Nebraska, who went on to the Final Four. For Baylor, their first ever trip to the BCS playoffs, they're in the second round. They hope to join our teams that have already made it to the Elite Eight. Griffin has yet to attempt a pass. He tried to option it. Griffin went down, and a couple of high-powered offenses, and for Baylor, we're starting off a little slow. On 3rd and 10, this has got to be a pass. Incomplete, 3 and out for the Baylor Bears. Looks like our Sun Bowl committee is about as bad as our Gator Bowl committee. Those patches are from the Brute Sun Bowl. I guess it's the Brute Hyundai Sun Bowl. Well, we promised you an offensive explosion, and if we don't deliver, I apologize. It seems to happen a lot where in a pregame you get promised something and it doesn't really go that way, so maybe we'll see a defensive battle between these two teams. Who knows? Not if Darren Thomas and company have anything to say about it. Quick first down for the Ducks, and they're already into midfield here at the Sun Bowl, El Paso, Texas. We still have going on at ABC, LSU playing Georgia, and we understand that one's getting pretty rowdy. So we'll wait to see what happens here, figure out where these teams are going in the Elite Eight. Second down and 9, Thomas to throw it again. Incomplete. And the defense for the Baylor Bears stepping up. Ahmad Dixon in on the defense there. So it'll be 3rd down and 9. First down, Ducks. And Moore staying on his feet down to the 20-yard line. I'm sorry, I wish I knew who that was that got it. But they go so fast on the no huddle, and the little ESPN scoreboard at the bottom doesn't tell you, which is a shame. Maybe something they'll fix for next year. They're going to go Wild Ducks. Quack, 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 all the way down to the 10. And I believe that was Josh Huff that ran it, number one. Second down and 2. Thomas, wide open man, first down. You can put it up. Yes, first down, Ducks. And Thomas tried to run it in himself on his own number. Unsuccessful attempt, second down and goal. Thomas will take it again, and this time he is successful. Touchdown, Oregon Ducks, Darren Thomas. And the Ducks take the lead over the Baylor Bears. This is the first time in the BCS that Baylor finds themselves behind. So on Baylor's opening drive, they go 3-and-out, and for the Oregon Ducks, on their opening drive, they easily go down the field. 8 plays, 50 yards, only took them 2 minutes. Look at this, the beautiful sight here at the Sun Bowl Stadium. This is really a neat place that UTEP gets to play in. Great sight for a second-round bowl game here. And these student-athletes have had a lot of great time, and kick return up to the 35. Student athletes have had a lot of fun here doing the bowl festivities. And Hyundai's done a really nice job putting on a great event for these two teams. Winner will move on to the big stage, the Elite Eight. Let's see if RG3 can pick things up. Well, they're not going to let him throw it yet. They decide to hand the ball off to Ganaway, Terrence Ganaway. Griffin the third will go down, so Baylor finds themselves in a little bit of a mess in the early going. This is the same team that scored 51 points last week. Griffin the third was brought down by Ricky Hamui. Third down and 16. Can the Bears fight their way out of this hole? No, they cannot. Another 3-and-out for Baylor. Wow. And the Ducks, once again, they'll get the ball just 60 yards away from the big yellow end zone, which is where they want to hit. That's the gold mine for Oregon. To LaMichael James, the future NFL running back. 10-yard carry, they're at midfield. Right on the Hyundai Sun Bowl logo. And James will get stopped that time for a loss. Couldn't get around. Third down and 4 for Thomas and the Ducks. Incomplete, and the Baylor Bears will now hold Oregon to a 3-and-out. How about the defense stepping up here? That's a big opportunity for Baylor to be able to get the ball back. For them, they got to be able to flip field position, though, right now, because Baylor's been stuck, and when Oregon gets it, they always get it around the 50, so a big victory for them would at least be trying to get the field to flip, or field position here to flip. See if they let RG3 throw it on first down. They will, and Griffin will take off. Griffin will go down again. The Bears, this is nothing like they've ever seen before, this speed from Oregon. And again, nowhere for Baylor to go. Third and 13, Robert Griffin, the third down the field, incomplete. He had it into his receiver's hands, and it will fall to the ground in another three and out. That is three consecutive three and outs for the Baylor Bears. And RG3, who has the most passing yards of any quarterback thus far in the bowl championship series, he threw for 400 yards last week. He's in a bit of a jam right now against these Oregon Ducks. That'll be a first down for Oregon. Right into Baylor Bear territory at the 45-yard line. Thomas will go five wide. And that'll do it for the first quarter. How about the defense is stepping up? At the end of the first here in El Paso, Texas, it's the Oregon Ducks 7 and the Baylor Bears 0 in the Sun Bowl. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to El Paso. We're winding down day one of round two of the BCS playoffs. We have the Liberty Bowl wrapping up. We've got the Sun Bowl here. And in prime time at 8 on ESPN, the Chick-fil-A Bowl, Alabama and Clemson from a sold-out Georgia Dome. Thomas tried to run it himself. He got the earlier touchdown. Doesn't happen, and Baylor defense stands up. On 4th and 7, another punt. And it'll be Baylor football at the 20. And again, Oregon is still winning this field position fight. Oh my goodness, Baylor still looking for their first down of the game. This is getting ugly in a hurry. Second down and 14 for the Bears. Heisman Trophy winner Robert Griffin III, he'll option. Down goes Griffin again. Why are you not letting him throw it? I don't understand the game plan unless they figured Oregon knew that it was going to be a bunch of passing on both sides. They thought, let's try to trip them up with some running. But they're not doing any tripping at all. It's third and long once again. RG3 will throw it short. It'll be caught. And that'll be it. Another three and out for Baylor. Wow, this is getting painful. Be duck football at the 45. Looks like James wanted a face mask, but Ed Hockley Jr. says, I didn't see nothing. And once again, the Ducks get some really good field position. Thomas to LaMichael James stays on his feet down to the 30-yard line. And when Oregon starts getting in rhythm, it can be deadly for the other team. And Michael James will get tackled. He loses two on the run. Takes it to a second down and 12. Well, Michael again will go down. He'll lose three that time. Third down and 15. First down for the Ducks on that throw and catch. I don't understand. On the passes, it doesn't seem like the D can get back there, but on the run, it seems like they're so quick to get back there and come up with a stop. That time they were really quick to get back there. They pressured Thomas. That one will fall incomplete. Second down and 10 at the 20. I guess you can officially put them in the... Yeah, oh, they're at the 15, I'm sorry. At the 15, so they are in the red zone. And now they are in the end zone. Touchdown, Oregon Ducks. Darren Thomas with the touchdown throw to DeAnthony Thomas. Thomas to Thomas for the score. And Oregon Ducks, 13 points against a Baylor squad that scored 51 last week. And a Baylor squad that has yet to get a first down. It's clutch time right now. RG3 needs to get his guys pumped up for this opening drive. Because things have the potential to get very messy in a hurry. Well, let's see what kind of adjustments they made. That's a nice start. That's a really good start for Baylor. First down of the game, and they're all the way down into duck territory. Now they go back to the option play. They go back to the same old, but I think they'll get 15 out of it. They're going to get lucky as there's a 15-yard face mask. Football will be moved up to the 34. Oh, and Griffin just threw that one away. He saw the defense coming, and he just said, nope, I'm not even going to try. Out of bounds. The offensive line, to do these running plays and to get some of these passes off, they're going to have to do a better job of trying to stop this Oregon Duck team. They hand the ball off again, and still nothing on the running game from Terrence Ganaway. Third down and 10, and Baylor does not want to have to settle for a field goal. Griffin the third. Incomplete. Threw that one right into double coverage. They will have to settle for the long field goal. It's going to be about 51 yards. And he makes it. He's still able to get it. Aaron Jones with the kick. It's good. How about the leg? We've seen some misses here in the BCS playoffs, but we've also seen some pretty impressive kicks also. But Oregon with 2 minutes and all their timeouts. Shoot, with this Ducks team with that kind of time, they can score 3, 4, 5 touchdowns before this half ends. And Thomas launched that one into double coverage, fell incomplete, and you got to give these D coordinators some dap, because when I see the quarterbacks throwing, they're throwing into double coverage, which means everyone must be pretty well covered down the field. That was another occasion. Thomas got it away, but just a really great job by the defense to come up with a tackle. Third down and 4. Can the Bears hold the Ducks to a 3-and-out? Which would be, it would be clutch for them to get one more offensive possession. There goes Thomas on the run and yanked back. How about that defensive play? This game moving so fast, can't get the numbers for you, but Thomas tried to run it, and he was yanked back. And all no you don't by that man. That gives Baylor 1 minute to try to move down the field. 2 timeouts. Let's see what RG3, the Heisman winner, has up his sleeve. Oh, man, that wasn't good at all. That's the freshman, Eco. I'm not even going to try that name. You saw how crazy that was on the back of that jersey. And that's going to be good for 9 yards for Baylor. Third and one. RG3 hasn't really had a chance to break free and use his feet yet. Let's see if he does it on this third and short. No, he's not. He's going to throw it. That's going to be good for a Baylor first down. And timeout number two. Number one on this drive, but number two overall for the Bears is called. With nobody in the backfield, RG3 throws it. Single coverage, almost intercepted. It was in the hands of that Oregon player, and that was John Boynette. Second and ten. Griffin there, he's going to use his feet, and he slides down at midfield. You saw Stuckley just staring into him. And RG3 decided to save his life and slide. That one was almost intercepted by Sloan. Or Gideon. Gilden. And another forced punt for Baylor. Into the end zone. That gives Oregon 13 seconds, three timeouts. If they want to try to put that offense to the test and move down the field 80 yards. See what they have in them. It doesn't appear, though. It looks like they're just going to give it to LaMichael James. And oh, my God. There goes LaMichael James. This was a get-out-of-the-half kind of situation. And LaMichael James with an 80-yard run blows by the Baylor defense. What a juke move from James. And that's maybe what Baylor thought. Baylor thought, hey, this is a run out the clock kind of play. They didn't really play to their fullest, and LaMichael James, he plays hard on every down, and that's why he's entering the draft next year. The Oregon Ducks 21-3 over the Baylor Bears. Incredible. Where else are you going to see the top 25 ranked teams playing each other week in and week out? You don't get that in the regular bowl games in real life. Ranked teams play unranked teams, and right now, Baylor, they need to figure something out in the locker room because it's not looking well for them. We'll send it up to the CBS studios with Greg Gumbel. We'll be right back. Welcome back to El Paso, Texas. Oregon holds a 21-3 lead over the Baylor Bears, and they have the ball once again on offense. Let's show you game tracks. Robert Griffin III, it's been that kind of a day for him. Football's into the turf, pressure on defense, and nothing but Oregon offense, capped off by this 80-yard run by LaMichael James to end the first half. Now Coach Kelly sending his team out there to add on to this lead. Oregon, after their disappointing showing last season, the Bowl Championship Series playoffs, this does not look like the same team that was eliminated in the second round. They already blew through BYU. Now they're taking out another B school in Baylor. Michael James with the run again. Not quite successful as his 80-yard gallop, but it is enough for a first down. I'm sure Coach Kelly quite satisfied with that. Another first down for the Ducks. Winner of this game will move on to play either Stanford or Michigan in the Elite Eight, which means we can either see an Oregon-Stanford rematch, or for the first time ever, Oregon-Michigan, or for the first time ever, Baylor-Stanford or Baylor-Michigan. This is a Pac-12 Big 12 showdown on the option. That's going to be on the turf. And that's Baylor football. The option was broken up and recovered by Mike Hicks, the junior safety from China Spring, Texas. And that just destroyed Oregon's momentum and gives opportunity and a new life to the Baylor Bears. Here comes RG3 fighting his way into Duck territory down at the 46-yard line, in between 46 and 47. Griffin will hand it off. That time it's going to be a first down. First down for Bear running back Terrence Gannaway. Gannaway will take it again, and he needs to get upfield quicker. He's spending way too much time trying to get around the piles. If he would spend more time running forward instead of left-right, he'd have a lot more yards right now. Second and 10. Bears will line up out of the pistol. They fake it to Gannaway this time. RG3 rolls down the field, has his man, first down. This is the closest that Baylor has been to scoring a touchdown all day. They give it to Gannaway again and again. Way too much time spent by him. Look at him. Right there, there is an opening if he would just cut up the field. But for some reason, they continue to go back to him. And call, for your, if you're a coach, call a draw play. Let him run plays up the middle. Quit with this left and right stuff. They're going to do it again. Oh my. It's, is this not ringing through to the coaches at all? This is not working. Draw plays or let your Heisman Trophy winner dictate the game. Don't put him in third and long situations. Really silly play calling for Baylor. Third down and 18 now. Griffin's forced to try to make up all this yardage, and when you put him into a third and long situation, your quarterbacks are going to make throws like that sometimes. Incomplete. Terrence Mitchell with the pass deflection. Another 51-yard field goal for Baylor. Can he make it 2 for 2? Just over the crossbar, Aaron Jones gets it from 50 yards out again. It's 21-6 now for the Bears. Should be 14-21. If, I mean, far be it for me to criticize anyone's play calling, but could easily be a 7-point game right now. Instead, it's a 15-point game. We'll see how the Ducks come back to counter after the missed opportunity last time. And they're going to counter like that. A play-action fake that completely fooled the Baylor Bear defense. Touchdown, Oregon Ducks. David Paulson, the tight end. Play-action fake. Everybody came to Thomas and to James. And Paulson, so close to being brought down at the shoelaces, but Oregon. Oh man, the Sun Bowl. It's getting loud for the 68% of Oregon fans that are here, but for the Baylor fans, they're starting to feel that all that money they spent on tickets to this one might not have been worth it. It's turning ugly in a hurry. This has been the biggest blowout we've had so far in our second round games. Yikes. We'll see if the play calling or anything gets better. I don't know how you let the quarterback that throws for 400 yards in the first round continue to hand the ball off to the running back on plays that are obviously not working. Now they're going to go five wide. Maybe they're going to let Griffin do it here. Can he be a hero? You can start off with a 3-yard pass and catch to his wide receiver. Second and 7. They're going to have to move in a hurry. Fakes the play, and there goes RG3. First down and slides down just past the 40, up to the 43-yard line. And Griffin is able to get that one away, 4 yards. Griffin to throw it again. Fades it up there. Wide open man. And why hasn't Baylor not been doing this all day? See how successful it is? Kendall Wright with the grab. The senior from Pittsburgh, Texas. Incomplete for that throw. Pleasant was in on the defense. That's Eddie Pleasant, the safety, the senior. Second and 10. They fake it. They throw it. First down. Not quite. Going to be just short. That was Sampson with the reception. Third down and 1. RG3 will option, and all the DBs, everybody broke as soon as they saw him option. Yeah, they came right in. Frustrating day for Robert Griffin, and Baylor will have to settle for a third field goal. Kick is good, 28-9. At least coach is pretty enthusiastic, but who would have thought after putting up, what was it, 4 touchdowns last week out of 400 yards? They'd come out this flat, and I know Oregon, very good team, ranked, of course, number 5 in the nation, but who would have thought they would have come out this flat? Quarterback sack. Number 18 for the Baylor Bears, and that's Tevin Elliott, defensive end. Takes us to a second down and 16. That's one of the few positive things that Baylor's been able to muster here today. And Elliott came in for the sack again, and Thomas just able to get it away, but it's going to go incomplete out of bounds. Third down and 16. Thomas. Intercepted by Baylor. Another turnover, and Baylor's going to get it at the 20-yard line. That one just looked like it flat out got away from Thomas. It was taken away by Chance Casey. Thomas took a chance by throwing that ball, and it was easily picked off. No excuses now. And they go with the draw play, and oh, look at how successful it was. 5 yards. The whole game they were going left and right and getting stopped for losses. They finally listen to me. And they get the draw play up the middle. RG3 will take off. Down to the 5s. They're going to get one more play off as the clock will stop on the first down. They're going to run it, it appears. Come on, get one more play. What are you doing? How do you waste a play? What is Baylor doing down there? They waste an opportunity to run an extra play. Well, this is it. We got one quarter to go. Baylor needs to score some touchdowns, and in a hurry. They got a fantastic opportunity right now. It's 28-9. Ducks lead the Bears. They fake it, Griffin. We'll run it. RG3, touchdown. Oh, you should have dove for it. That's your season is on the line. I respect that you got to slide not get hurt, but your season on the line. You got to dive for these things. Second and goal. Now you're wasting so much time. They go right back to the handoff. It doesn't work ever. Third and goal. And they're going to throw it. Now Griffin will run it, and there he gets it in. Touchdown, Robert Griffin the third. And I would have to guess that at this point, it's two-point conversion time. RG3, and what's been a rather frustrating day for him. They're going to kick the extra point. I'm surprised. I would think that it's two-point conversion territory. Two more touchdowns for Baylor, and that would give them the lead. So they're going to need their defense to either come up with another turnover or come up with some quick stops on Oregon. Try to make this comeback, this improbable comeback, possible. Not if they give time. Well, Thomas tries to run it, and it'll be a tackle by Elliot Coffey, linebacker, senior linebacker. That's great. Elliot Coffey is from Sugarland, Texas. So you got sugar and coffee. I don't know if anyone else finds the humor in that I do. Maybe it's just me. But Elliot Coffey from Sugarland with a nice cup of coffee on the side for Darren Thomas. Ripping into the turf, second and 12. They option to LaMichael James, and down goes LaMichael James. This is what Baylor was hoping for. They're only two touchdowns away. Oregon needs to play with a little more passion and energy. Well, there you go. That's plenty of passion and energy. Thomas goes deep for the other Thomas. I believe that's the other Thomas, that number six. Let me get a close-up. Well, they're not going to show us. Oregon looking to seal this one with one more score. LaMichael James. He'll get brought down easily. Running game's been lacking on both sides here today. Second down and 10 in the red zone. We have a flag. Delay of game. That will push the Ducks back. Just a touch bit, it'll stop the clock. Michael James takes on the draw, and down we go with Michael James. Baylor used their first time out. Third down and 18. Thomas will throw it. Thomas sheds one defender. He takes off, and he's finally brought down. Timeout is called, and Oregon will go to attempt a 50-yard field goal. No good. So the 50-yard field goal, Baylor makes two of them, and Oregon misses their 50-yarder from Alejandro Maldonado Durandolo. I know, not even close. But anyway, 2 minutes to go, down by two touchdowns. This is it for Baylor. Incomplete, oh man. Easy pass, and it was dropped. Second down and 10. Griffin to throw it. And that's going to be a first down up to the 46. Clock will stop temporarily. And they decide to spike it. I'm not a big fan of spiking the ball when you have over a minute and 40 to go, because that just kind of kills your momentum when you're trying to run this quick no huddle offense to get these points on the board. Now, you're already down to a third down. You see why Baylor's been struggling today. 2 for 10 on third down conversion. That's never good if your team wants to win. RG3 will go for it all. That's caught. No! Oh my goodness, it was dropped. Oh man, that could have been the game-saving score. That was Sampson who had it and dropped it. This is it for the Bears. 4th and 10. Griffin going for the end zone again and again. It's going to go incomplete. Robert Griffin III did all he could in this game, but between bad play calling and receivers not being able to catch pass him, and Griffin was putting these things on the dot, and his receivers just were not able to come up with it. Baylor, their last desperation, will burn their final timeout. And if I were the Bears, I'd burn any game plan that you had for this game. Never, ever use it again. This was, we've seen Baylor lose by some pretty big margins this year, but I think that might have been one of the ugliest defeats for the Bears this season. It'll be 3rd and 17 quickly after Darren Thomas twice was just running around and dropping down. So with this, it appears that Oregon will move on to have a date with either Stanford or Michigan. Either a battle of Michigan for the first time or a rematch with Stanford. And that's been the one team that's haunted Andrew Luck his entire college career. The one team he's never been able to get those multiple wins against. Kellen Moore has more wins against the Oregon Ducks than Andrew Luck has. The final 15 seconds will run off the clock, and the Oregon Ducks will be going to the Elite Eight for the first time since 2009, when they were in the Final Four. No, it was 2009. They were in the Final Four, where they lost to Boise State. They would go on to the national title game to lose to Arizona. The Ducks will walk away with this one 28-16. Your play of the game. Why not? That was a really nice run. Michael James, good luck to you in the NFL, but your season's not over yet. The Ducks can now sit comfortably here in Texas and wait to find out where their next destination is. If Stanford wins, we can all but assume that the game will be the Rose Bowl. Can you imagine Stanford and Oregon in the Rose Bowl? Because should Alabama win, they would probably take the Orange Bowl, and should Oklahoma State win, they would take the Fiesta Bowl. If Oklahoma State loses, then next in line would be Stanford. So a win for Stanford would give them the Rose Bowl. If Stanford loses, well, then the next pick would go to the number 5 team, which would be Oregon. And again, chances are they would take the Rose Bowl. So I think we can all but assume at this point that Oregon is smelling roses and that they are going to go to the Rose Bowl game, which would be the first time back at the Rose Bowl since the 2009 season, when they went to the Final Four and lost in the Rose Bowl game, one of two Rose Bowl games, as part of the Rose Bowl Final Four. They lost to Boise, so Oregon, smelling the roses. Yes, indeed, the Oregon Ducks, Pac-12 champs. Let's take a look at your numbers. Here for your post-game show, Darren Thomas. Dominant as always on the Baylor side. RG3, what a fall from grace from what he did last week. Rushing game, awful numbers. 12 attempts for negative 5 yards, and a part of that was just really bad, bad play calling for the Baylor Bears. Michael James, 10 runs. 84 yards. A lot of them came on that 80-yard run. So really, take away that one 80-yard run, 9 carries for 4 yards. James didn't do a whole heck of a lot better on the rushing. On the receiving, D'Anthony Thomas and David Paulson led your charge. And do your best. Find some winners out of that on the receiving core. Into the defense. K.J. Morton, how about 10 solo tackles? And on the Ducks side, you can run down the line. There's your defense numbers for yourself. If you want to read them all, pause it. If not, we're moving on to the team stats. Both had same number of first downs, but who would have thought in this offensive showcase, Oregon Ducks, 351 yards to the Baylor Bears, 149. Passing yards, too. 134 to Oregon's nearly 300. 2 turnovers for the Ducks, but Baylor couldn't really convert, do anything with them. And again, you'd have to imagine that if the play calling was a little better for Baylor, they had to kick 3 field goals, if you remember. You take those 3 field goals away, take those 9 points away, and turn them into 21 points, the Baylor Bears are moving on to the next round, and the Baylor Bears are potentially playing in the Rose Bowl instead of sitting at home. In total yards, 514 to 286. Man, oh man. Well, that'll do it here for CBS Football, the Hyundai Sun Bowl. Let's show you your bracket, and then you're going to want to go to ESPN because already underway. The Chick-fil-A Bowl, number 2, Alabama, versus the Clemson Tigers.